Hi, this is JP Morgan. Today on the Slanted Lens, we're down here in Hollywood. I've got Ariel with me. We're gonna test out the new 70 to 180 millimeter lens from Tamron for Sony. This is a great lens. It's the last in that three-part series. It's that small telephoto you carry in your bag, small form factor, 2.8 all the way through. We're gonna test this lens out and just see how well it does. So far, I've been using this lens this morning shooting aerial. It's been really easy to use. It's been fast. The autofocus has been fast, which has been really one of my biggest concerns. Does the autofocus work quickly? And it does. I'm gonna test it now also in video mode to just make sure it's gonna track and do well in that video mode. Super lightweight, super small, easy to use, been really good. So I really wanna take a look at colors. So I photographed aerial against this red wall here and just see exactly how this lens works with the sensor. I mean, it's not muddy, it gives you great contrast, and I think the color is pretty. It looks really nice. So I felt like the color and the lens did exactly what it needed to for the color. It's not muddying it up or causing any issues, letting the sensor do its work. I'm now gonna test and just see how this lens does in video mode as far as the auto focus tracking. So at 70 millimeters, I'll have her walk to me and then walk back, then I'll do one at 180 millimeters and just see how it stays on the face. So there's a look at the autofocus tracking in video mode. At 70 millimeters, it's absolutely fine. It stays right with her. So at 180 millimeters, it stays with her, but sometimes it's just a little less responsive, but it stays with her, you know, something to keep in mind. So we just got done shooting some images. Let's take a look at some of them we shot walking around down here in Hollywood. So why would you buy this lens? There's a couple of reasons. One is it's not near as expensive as a Sony G Master lens. It's gonna be a 70 to 200. It's much less expensive. So you're gonna be able to buy a couple of these for the same price as one of those. And it's as sharp. It's very, very sharp. It's gonna give you a beautiful, sharp image. It's gonna be fast to be able to use, and it's gonna be lightweight. Whereas the 70 to 200 from Sony is not gonna be in that category. A 70 to 180 is a slight compromise because of that telephoto. The reality is, at 180 millimeters, that's about now 200 millimeters, if I just walk forward a little bit. But like I say, when you move in, changes the perspective slightly, but you get the same effect. Focus falls more out of focus in the background when you move in, the same as when you zoom in. So it really accomplishes the same things, and I think the compromise is worth it because of the price, with being half the price, and also because of the weight and the slim fat form factor. So who do I think this lens is for? But this lens is really about portraits, street portraiture, advertising, fashion, those kinds of applications, because you get that longer lens, 2.8, so the background's gonna fall nicely out of focus. It's gonna track, the autofocus is gonna track, it makes it easy to photograph someone you're moving around and shooting. So when you're using strobes, and I use strobes with lenses all the time, I shot some here this morning, I really need a lens that's not gonna change. It's gonna stay at that constant 2.8. because now I can keep my settings, I can zoom in and shoot, I can zoom back out and shoot, just makes it really seamless to use. If you're a traveling photographer doing nature and stuff where you're traveling the world, this series of lenses is perfect for that because it's just so easy to pack several lenses in a bag and go, and you're not feeling like you're carrying a ton of weight all the time. In video mode, this is great because if you're setting up for an interview, you can just frame in on the person, let the background fall nicely out of focus, and it doesn't matter where you're at. It gives you a great image, it gives you a great interview setup. So all those things added together, I think makes this a very positive lens. The 28 to 75 was an incredible lens from Tamron, and people loved it. We use it here at the Slanted Lens all the time on our Sony rig. This is gonna fall in that same category. Now it gives us a little longer lens so that things can fall more out of focus in the background. But they've successfully made a lens that fits into the series, 67 millimeters, so it matches everything else that they've done, including their 20, 24, and 35. So it makes a great package all the way across the board. Lightweight, nicely done. I feel like it's a positive lens and I can't wait to keep shooting on it. So there's some thoughts on the new 70 to 180 millimeter lens. So keep those cameras rolling and keep on clicking.